Video is going to go over our fourth project for the semester, the research essay, otherwise known as entering the conversation. So we have been working all semester on looking at academic writing and research as entering a larger conversation. We've used the Burkean parlor to think about this conversation as an ongoing discussion that already started and will continue on even once we've left. So now it's time for you to join the conversation. You've already done the work to do a research question. You've done a lot of work on your annotated bibliography to research, read, and analyze sources that are appropriate to answer your research question. And now it's time to decide what you want to say and how you want to put your oar in and answer a question and join the conversation. So it's really important to note that the research essay is required to pass English 1010. The 6-page essay is a department requirement, and it is the requirement that really does make this class transferable to any other college. So let's take a look at what you're going to be doing. It's pretty open, but in an essay of at least 6 complete pages, create an argument that answers your approved research question for a general academic audience. Your essay should synthesize resources to present compelling evidence about your argument. Paragraphs should be clear and unified. Evidence should be introduced and analyzed completely. You should use a mixture of summary, quote, and paraphrase as appropriate. Cite your sources correctly and responsibly in either MLA or APA style, and be sure to include a works cited or reference page, depending on the style you're using. Now, the 6 complete pages are 6 complete pages of writing. This is double-spaced, and it does not include your reference page or works cited page. It is just the body of your essay. So before you start writing, you're going to use your research question and your annotated bibliography to write a preliminary thesis. This is kind of your starting argument. You're going to complete a synthesis matrix, just like we did for the synthesis essay, and you're going to isolate emergent themes and topics, and then you're going to use this matrix to put all of your research into it so that you can start categorizing and grouping your sources. Once you do that, you're going to decide if you need more research for any of the themes that you're going to be talking about or arguing about in your paper. Once you start to plan and write, we're going to outline our main claims, reasons, and evidence. We're going to be using classical argument structure, so we're going to be going over that as well. You're going to draft your essay using clear signal phrases to introduce your sources. And again, make sure that you're using a combination of summary, paraphrase, and direct quotations. If your whole research essay is nothing but quotations, you're not going to be meeting all of the requirements. So you really want to think about your rhetorical situation. What is your purpose? Are you trying to inform or persuade? How have you addressed your context, which is an academic context for an academic audience? And how have you met the audience's needs? And things that you're going to want to think about are the types of sources you're using, how you're introducing them, how you're analyzing them, and how you're citing them. You want to check over your sources. Make sure that you've introduced every single summary, paraphrase, or quotation with a signal phrase. You shouldn't be dropping any research in randomly. You need to provide in-text citations for every direct quote and paraphrase. And you need to make sure that every source that you refer to is in your Works Cited and reference page, and that every source on your Works Cited and reference page is also cited in the text itself. You're going to make sure that you use those T paragraphs that we talked about. You want to analyze and discuss each piece of evidence before moving on to the next. And you want to make sure that you are achieving synthesis. So that means every claim you make should have at least 2 sources or pieces of evidence. So again, this is not 2 quotes from the same source. These are 2 different sources corroborating one another to support the claims that you're making. Your introduction should immediately draw your audience's attention to the specific issue. It should provide a clear thesis, and it should give some sense of what they say, what the conversation is that you are addressing. Your thesis should control your essay. You can think about revising it as you write. So once you finish writing and you're going through the revision process, you're going to look back at your thesis and make sure that it still does preview and control your argument. And then your conclusion should leave your audience with a final thought that emphasizes the importance of your argument. So that's that. So what? Like, why should we care about this? Your conclusion should have some indication of why your specific audience should care about your specific argument. So as you're working, you're going to make sure that you look at those minimum requirements. These are really, really important for this particular project. The big ones that are super important are it has to be a minimum of 6 complete double-spaced pages. That is an absolute must. You cannot get a C or higher on this essay unless you're writing 6 complete pages. And the other one that is an absolute must is that the essay has to cite and use at least 6 sources from the PGCC library, including one peer-reviewed scholarly article. It should not have more than 2 resources from the general internet, and those resources should not be cited more than the library. So 6 pages and 6 sources are the minimum to earning a 70% or higher on this assignment. You cannot earn a passing grade on this unless you meet those 2 basic requirements. So don't forget, students are expected to show their work by completing the required process work. If you have not completed an annotated bibliography, or if your annotated bibliography needs revision, you need to make sure that you do that before you submit this research essay, or this essay may not be accepted. So if you have any questions about the upcoming project and your final big research essay, make sure that you're reaching out and asking them, either through office hours or email. Don't forget, we have the Campus Writing Center where you can also get extra help on this.